Okay, I might do a little video on some of the stuff that I got at the Dollarama, and some of it came from the Great Canadian Dollar Store. They sort of, some have better prices than the other guy, and some have selection of things that the other one doesn't have, and stuff like that. So, and some of the stuff's just sort of neat, so I don't know. But, Dollarama, they had these the other day. I hadn't seen these before. They're pre-seasoned cast iron fry pan. They're $4, so it's like, it's worth a try, I guess. You know, like they're just a Chinese cast iron and everything, but they're not a bad little fry pan. So, for kind of like single serve kind of thing. I was looking up like what's the price of these sort of the generic little cast iron fry pans. Like the cheapest I could find was like seven something, so $4 seems like a pretty good price. So not that I really need one, but whatever. So. And let's see, this is some Dollarama as well. I bought these before, but they still had their camping section was out, so I $3, these magnesium fire starters. You got like the ferro rod on the side of them. I like this one basically. So it's got the ferro rod on the side and it's magnesium block, and then there's like the scraper, which is, looks like a piece of a hacksaw blade. Got the teeth so you can scrape the magnesium off and then you can strike it there. So they're, they go for about the same price in the States. I think they're $1.50 or $2 or something like that, like Harbor Freight or something like that. So they do work, but they're all right, and they don't get, you know, they don't get wet. So they're good to have in your hunting bag. So there's that. Let's see, this was, yeah, this was from Great Canadian Dollar Store. They had these flashlights. I got one that's sort of got like a yellowish color to it, and it's kind of a rubberized coating on the top and bottom here. This one's like a camo kind of thing, and it's got the hook that folds out and a magnet on it, so you can stick it onto stuff. And it's quite, really, really quite bright. See? And you actually take them apart. There's screws here, and there's, I think it's like a couple triple A's or a couple double A's. I forget what's in it, but the Dollarama had these ones. I don't think they have them anymore. They got something similar, but you can find these pretty much anywhere. But these actually work really well. I've got two of these ones, the camo ones, and my other one. And I figured I'd pick them up. They're good. Good light to have like in your vehicle or something, because you can stick it to metal things or you're working on something or hang it off stuff. And they're bright enough to be useful, but they're durable. They're not, you know, some of the cheaper lights are kind of dodgy. But, so I got one of those. I saw these. I wasn't really totally sure what this even was, but the fondue burner, which he still does fondue anyway, I don't know. But first I was thinking it might be useful to make like char cloth with, but then I looked at it and it's got like this sort of looks like fiberglass insulation in it, and like a perforated piece of metal down inside. But it's basically for like a fondue set. You have like the pot and then the stand, and this sits underneath, and you put, well, it's fondue fuel, you can buy that, but it's just like alcohol. You put it in, and you can turn this back and forth, and it opens or closes these little holes, and it'll adjust the flame. So it's kind of like a, is it Trangia or gas stoves? And this is a little snuffer. But it was $3, I think it was. Yeah, you can get them cheaper, I think, but actually, there was someplace online they wanted like quite a lot of money for one of these things, but But it might be good build a little stand for it and for boiling water in the woods or just there's several different kinds of fuel you can burn in them. Or different kinds of alcohol or whatever. But anyway, let me give it a try sometime and see how it works. But you know, for pulling water in the house, the power goes out or something. Kind of good for that, I guess. So I thought that was kind of neat, but I don't know why like there's so much fondue stuff now. Like, didn't that go out in the 60s or 70s? I don't know. They had these paring knives. They were $2.50, I guess. At the Great Canadian Dollar Store. It says high carbon stainless steel blade, it says. But there's a little cover with it. But the blade is actually painted too. It's like this one's red. It's kind of like hunter orange. Put up the light. You can see the blade goes into about there. Yeah, so it's just like a little stick tang or whatever. But I thought for like a camping knife or something, it'd be great because it's like orange and you dropped it, you'd be able to find it. So, and they're cheap, like they're $2.50. They had another one I think that was a little bit cheaper but didn't have the cover with it. But they come in quite a different bunch of colors. Red one, orange one, I think there was like a green one or something. So, but they cut really well. I've used it the last few days, cutting up stuff in kitchen, and they got this coating, which I think they mentioned that it's non-stick coating, easy to clean, dishwasher safe. It's a 3.5-inch blade, so. But it seemed to cut well. So anyway, thought that was kind of neat. They had these at the Great Canadian Dollar Store as well. It's a 6-inch sharpening stone, which I think it's a double. Yeah, I guess there's two different colors to it. Like a, it's like a coarse and a fine sort of. Yeah, I guess, I don't know if you can see the dip too. This is lighter and darker. But this was $1.50, and I looked up YouTube videos. People were buying these cheap, like really, really cheap Chinese sharpening stones, and they were. Couldn't find one that was like, I don't know, it was $2.50 or $3 or $4 was like the cheapest one that the guy was. So I don't know, you sure know what it is. It's probably a carborundum or whatever. But I guess you can use it with water with it or oil. I don't know. If I put it in water, it might just fall apart. But I don't know. We'll see. See how it works out. But for $1.50, you can't really go wrong. So I was kind of surprised how cheap it was. Then they had this stuff here, Tide, the laundry bar soap. These were $1.50, but they do smell really good. But anyway, I started looking at it, and it was like only, and I was like, what is this? And you look on the back, and it says Procter & Gamble Home Products Limited, Mumbai. So that's Bombay now, I guess, or was Bombay, I mean, but made in India, obviously, so I was like, maybe that's rupees, so I looked up what rupees, and that's the symbol for, so it's 10 rupees, or only 10 rupees, it says, and were made 2012, but I looked up what 10 rupees was worth, Canadian is like 18 cents, so, but these were like $1.50. But I don't see that stuff. You see like the sunlight ones. It's good to have around. You can clean stains out of clothing and stuff, or hand wash it kind of thing. So I just found it kind of neat that Tide soap from India, which you can take your dirty clothes and your bar of soap and march into the Ganges and clean it up. You even got pictures, see? Look, it goes from brown to white. So that's good. So, There's a weird thing about this. If you look up like bar soap on YouTube, there's like a couple channels where people have like a bar of this kind of like soap or this stuff, or I guess normal hand soap, and they're like carving pieces off it with like a razor knife, and I don't know what is going on there, but anyway, it's some of the stuff that I found the last couple trips. I think that's like 3 trips. There's some other stuff too, but most of it was just boring. So that's sort of stuff I figured it was sort of a bit more interesting. So good deals. And the different, like the different dollar stores, like they get stuff just sent to them, I think. I don't know how Great Canadian Dollar Store works, but Dollarama, they get stuff and they send it to the different stores. So some, I think one store will have this stuff, but the other ones won't, or you get some of the big ones in the cities. Like they probably have all kinds of stuff. But like Dollarama, they only go to $4 is the most expensive stuff, like that fry pan or something like this, or high end stuff. Great Canadian Dollar Store, they have stuff that's above that. So, but they have stuff that's like a dollar basically, all the way up to some stuff $7-$8 or more. So they have a bit more selection, a bit more sort of, you know, higher end stuff, I guess. Everyone explain it, so, or describe it. So anyway, thanks for watching, and we will talk to you later.